Chicago area viewers of the Donahue Show are familiar with a program called Bubblegum Digest, which is produced and airs on the NBC station here in Chicago, a piece of which I'd like to show you at this time. This is an actual newscast, and the people delivering the news are all under, what, 13?
We'll be talking to famous pantomimist Marcel Marceau.
And we'll be going to a Blackhawks practice session.
Bubblegum Digest with Allyson Johnson, H.L. Silets, and the Bubblegum Digest team. And now, here's H.L.
The North Carolina presidential primary had a surprising turnout this week. Ronald Reagan won over President Ford on the Republican side for the first time, and Jimmy Carter had his fifth consecutive win on the Democratic front. The next primaries will take place April 6th in New York and Wisconsin.
Superintendent Joseph P. Hannon and the Board of Education decided to cut 8.5% of all public school employees' salary. They will do this by starting summer vacation 11 days early and not paying the employees during spring vacation.
I'd like you now to meet one half of that anchor team from the NBC Bubblegum Digest program. Here is the future John Chancellor of the Chicago area. Would you kindly welcome H.L. Silets? Mr. Silets. H.L., I'm a very insecure fellow. You must know that. This is such a competitive business, and they're all out there trying to get your show, and everybody's trying to beat you. But I'm going to just have to bear up today, and I'm going to ask you to help me at least, will you, with today's program. And I'd like you to begin by introducing our guest today. I'm going to give you the mic and get out of here, okay? H.L.
Can you hear me? Okay. There's a great performer. Love him. He's on many commercials. I saw him on the Mike Douglas show. Been on Dick Cavett's show. Fantastic little guy. Mason Reese.
Show, but after that, no, I wasn't scared.
Why is your boogish mode commercial such a hit? I'll call you the boogish mode kid now.
Well, it happened was that the word actually is smorgasbord, but
that's funny, I never knew that.
But they made a list of words to say, and I just happened to pick boogish mode, which is smorgasbord in Swedish. That's by coincidence.
Do you know any more Swedish?
No. That's the only thing I know.
I've been reading a little bit in your book of memoirs here, and I know you've been hosting and making guest appearances on many shows. Which one do you think you like best?
Oh, by snap of a finger, my Douglas show.
Okay.
Well, I've co-hosted about 3 times, appeared about 30 times.
30?
Yeah, but I've co-hosted 3 times.
Right. Is it fun?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. They have a lot of surprises for me.
What kind of surprises, or is that confidential?
Well, I was dancing, and turned out that they had a water hose. You see, I was dancing Singing in the Rain. So it just turned out that they had a water hose planted on me. So what was to happen was, the top man was to make the shower spray on Mike and myself, but it turned out that he was relaxing. The top man was relaxing and didn't know his cue. And Mike had to say Singing in the Rain about 5 times. And then he moved away. And then I looked up, and then something happened, and it fell on me.
Right,
instead of going on Mike. And the whole set was, they have a lot of things. Yes.
What other shows have you appeared on?
Dick Cavett. Hopefully, I will be going up. The only reason why I stopped here was to do Phil's show and to go out to California to do possibly a couple of shows out there and to meet some producers and stuff like that.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
How many commercials do you think you've done since you started?
I'd say about an estimated guess of 30.
Oh, how old were you when you started?
I was 4 and a half.
How old are you now?
I am 10. I was 10 April 11th.
Oh, that's great. You've been doing it for 5 and a half years.
That's right.
A lot of experience.
Yeah.
What were some of your favorite commercials to do?
I think, it was either Thick and Frosty, which was, it was like an ice cream milkshake that was fantastically thick. And I had only one thing to do on the commercial. Was to go, was to enjoy it. And obviously I went, oh, so that I'd get more and more of it. So I gained a couple of pounds on that commercial.
Does any of this interfere with your schoolwork?
No. What happens is I bring schoolwork with me. And that's what I do. I bring schoolwork with me. And usually I do schoolwork.
Where do you go to school?
I go to school, professional children's school.
Where is that?
That's in Manhattan.
And you live in Manhattan now?
Yeah, I always do.
Oh, do you travel around a lot, you know, when you do your commercials, or are they basically mostly in Manhattan?
Well, I've done commercials in South Carolina. I did a commercial in Boston. But mostly, I do the commercials in the New York area.
Well?
So that I don't have to travel too far to be able to have to do them.
Yeah. Well, thanks a lot for coming, Mason. It was really a pleasure talking to you and meeting you.
Jeff Ernst has a special feature for us on the Blackhawks.
We're at Chicago Stadium to see the Blackhawks, Chicago's ice hockey team, during one of their practice sessions. The hockey season runs from October to April. During that time, they play 80 games, 40 in Chicago and 40 away, and then the Stanley Cup playoffs take place at the end of May. After the practice session, we had the opportunity to talk to a few of the Blackhawk players. First, we talked to center number 21, Stan Mikita. How did you get to be one of the best centers in the league?
Well, I don't know if I am one of the best or not, Jeff, but I think it was a lot of practice.
Here's hoping that the Blackhawks will make it to the Stanley Cup playoffs. This is Jeff Ernst reporting from Chicago Stadium.
Our movie critic, Pam Erens, has a review of Jack and the Beanstalk for us today.
Pam? Jack and the Beanstalk opened in Chicago this weekend. It's a completely animated film and has good sound effects, but I couldn't say the animation was great. There are some pretty funny scenes in the film, but these are ruined by too many songs. You could tell the kids in the theater were getting restless, especially during the corny singing. Somehow, Jack and the Beanstalk appeared to me to be a rather mediocre film.
HL has some comments for us on the Oscars now.
One thing is for sure, no G-rated movies will get an Oscar because there are none in the running. I feel the kids should be able to have movies that appeal to them. The only worthwhile movies for us are PG, and a lot of them contain material that our parents won't let us see. For example, Lucky Lady is off limits, and if they let us see The Sunshine Boys, which I saw, it's just a big bore. Why don't movie makers consider making many general audience films anymore, such as Gone with the Wind, The Sound of Music, and The Wizard of Oz? Maybe it's because they feel that today's kid is a TV freak. But maybe it's just because kids aren't valued very highly as an audience. We buy tickets, too. Movie makers, answer us.
Here we have Marcel Marceau, the greatest master of the art of mime. Bonjour et bienvenue.
Merci.
Mr. Marceau, do you think you could give us a short definition of the word pantomime?
Pantomime is the way to express feelings and situations without words. You can express situations which are comic, funny, tragic. Yes. It's showing men, women, children, all life in different aspects without words.
Merci beaucoup et bonne chance avec votre livre.
Merci, c'est gentil, yes. Merci.
Arthur, I can't believe all the mail you've been getting. What have people been writing about?
Earl Dillon wrote that he gets good grades, does his homework, and has good manners, but he doesn't have any friends. Earl, if you have a bike and you are outside riding it, and you see some buddies that you would like to make friends with, ask them, do you want to ride my bike? Sharon McLaurin has two brothers who keep following her around instead of being with someone their own age. Sherry, whenever they follow you around, tell them, stop following me or I'll tell. Lainey Feldstein, who is in first grade at Anchee Emmett School, thinks her board work is too hard. Lainey, please send me another note advising me what sort of work it is.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we're back. Thank you. Along with Mason Reese and Allyson Johnson, we have Jeff Ernst, one of our feature reporters, and Pam Erens, and our own dear Abby, dear Arthur Smith.
Arthur, may I ask, sir, I've just been looking over some of the mail that you've received. Dear Art, it's not how you're known, however.
No.
My name is, she gives her name here, and I want to know how to marry Michael Jackson of the Jackson 5. Now, how do you possibly answer a letter like that?
Well, it seems like, you know, I looked at the writing, and it seems like she was really small. So I told her that she shouldn't worry about getting married until she gets big.
Oh. Gives her name. I am 6 years old. I would be very happy, Arthur, if you would read my letter on television. I think your show is groovy. I think she, well, you must get mail from a lot of girls.
Oh, yeah.
you're not getting stuck up, are you?
No.
Do you think about that? You know, a lot of kids, probably they see you on television and they figure that you must be kind of, you know.
No. Although I have too many letters piled up as it is.
No.
It's about 200 or so.
Really? 200 letters? Dear Arthur, I love plants. So do my cats. They jump in the planter and scratch out the dirt on my rugs. How can I keep them from doing this and keeping the dirt off my rug?
I told her to put her plants on top of the refrigerator. And if they still keep getting up there and scratching all the dirt out on the rugs, come someplace where the cats cannot climb up to scratch out the dirt.
I see. Okay, good idea.
Yeah.
Here's a person who says, I hope your show will stay on. You're not worried about the show being off, are you?
Not really.
Okay. My little sister all the time gets into, she says, my mother, apparently she's stealing things, or she's taking things, and her mother thinks it's her. Yeah, did you remember how you handled that?
Which one is it about?
Well, here's another one. Let me give this other one.
Okay.
Dear Arthur, if your brother snores at night, what do you do? From Eric.
Oh, I told him to tell his brother to go see a doctor. Because I got enough. I got a first letter from him about the same thing. He said it was getting really serious.
But the mail keeps coming in. You're gonna probably,
really?
Yeah. And you don't have that much time. Do you ever get complaints about the kids on the show?
No, I only have one letter concerning that they talk too fast.
Yeah. And what was your recommendation to the others on the program?
I try to have them to slow down.
Pam, you are a movie reviewer as well as an interviewer and other things. You choose the movies that you're going to review?
Not really.
Mm. And the last movie you reviewed was?
Ride a Wild Pony.
Mm. You liked it?
It's pretty good.
Yeah. It seems that there's always something about the movies. Did you ever see anything that you liked everything about?
Gone with the Wind.
Oh, really? You gave that a good review then?
I didn't review it.
Oh, I see. You just saw. When you go to review, do you take a pencil and paper? Or?
Yeah, I take paper. I scribble, but usually it gets all messed up.
Yeah, what didn't you like about Jack and the Beanstalk?
Well, I don't know. It's just that I didn't think it was really... It was too boring for little kids to watch.
Jeff, I saw you interviewing Stan Mikita. Were you a little nervous?
No, he helped me a lot.
Did he?
Yeah.
He was kind of nice. He wasn't a show-off or anything?
Yeah, well, I was more nervous than him. He just said, settle down, because... Yeah. Everything's going to be all right. I'll help you out.
Yeah.
He kind of extended the questions on it. Sitting there, please make them longer so I don't have to...
I've said that many times to guess myself. Mason, you've worked for WNBC in New York, I know.
Yeah.
In fact, you did a piece on... didn't you do a piece interviewing Santa Clauses?
Yeah.
What was the story on that?
Well, we had to do a piece about... We had to do a piece about all the Santa Clauses raising money for all kinds of charities, and we had a little bit of trouble making it though because it was very noisy and there was traffic and the lighting. We were running out of time and we were running out of money on making the film, so the lighting was very bad. Lighting was very bad. Everybody was tired. It wasn't on a day where you should be working.
And here's that piece. Let's.
Yes.
Give me a big bag of Santa Claus to squeeze down, especially with a big bag of toys on his back. But it's just big enough to collect money for the Volunteers of America. And at Christmas time, they give it to poor people. Every year after Thanksgiving, the Volunteers of America give this sidewalk a pep talk here in Times Square. Then the Santas take their post in front of the stores in New York. Colonel Walter Nash gave the Santas some do's and don'ts. He said, don't eat garlic and keep your whiskers clean. Don't promise kids that they'll bring them all the presents they ask for. And when they ask you why are there so many Santa Clauses around, say that you are not the real Santa Claus, but only his helper.
Now, I'd like to hear a ho, ho, ho from all of our Santa Clauses, and I want you to lift your bells and ho, ho, ho. Let's go.
We have some people in the audience who would like to question not only Mason, but Allyson, Jeff, Pam, and Arthur as well. And HL is over in that island.
Okay.
You'll help me.
Stand up.
Okay.
Wow.
like to ask you, since you're only 10 and have done so much, what are your goals? Where can you go?
Well, my goals is when I get older. Well, to be alive. That's one of my goals. And I think I'd like to be an actor when I get older. Well, not saying that I don't act now, but I would like to be somebody in the movies, somebody like John Wayne or some tough guy in a movie or something.
You know, he was just here yesterday, Mason. You missed him by one day.
No.
Don't you?
Yeah. Okay. I do an imitation of John Wayne. Ho, 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 pilgrim.
Fascinated with the Bubblegum Digest, the background of the children. Can you tell me how you got into this show?
Well, I got a letter from my school, my headmaster and my drama teacher, saying, go try out. There were like 140 kids trying out, and I auditioned about three or four times, and then I got a call from Diane saying that I had made it and I was going to be one of the co-hosts.
How old are you, Allyson?
11.
What's harder, preparing the news, reading it, or interviewing, or what?
Oh, that's a hard question. I'd probably say interviewing is hardest, but I think it's really fun anyway. I don't care.
Have you ever done a bad interview? I mean, is anything kind of that you weren't proud of happened yet?
No, not yet.
Everything's been good, huh?
Yeah.
See, I wonder what that's like. Jeff, you want to be a sports announcer, or do you want to be your own sweat sock? You going to play ball, or what are you going to do?
I kind of want to see my dad's got a manufacturer's rep company, and I've been looking forward to taking that over someday.
Well, it's good to be right out front with it, Jeff. A lot of kids sneak up on the old man. I'm really...
And maybe someday I'd like to be a sportscaster.
Got a question over here.
Certainly.
Okay. Yes, I was wondering how Mason got started in the commercial.
Well, we had this neighbor in our building, and I was only two at the time, and the neighbor said, oh, my son's in commercials, and I love your son. He's so cute. Get him in commercials. We have this agent. You contact our agent. She'll get you into something. Don't worry about it. So my mother said, no, I don't think so. My son, you know, he can't talk yet. He's not verbal. He doesn't do anything. He's just a cute little person that's mischievous.
That's what?
That's mischievous.
Oh.
That is the right.
That's right.
Yeah. So what happened was, the lady bugged my mother for 2 years. And when I was four, my mother said, well, now he's verbal. And I want to get him, I just want to capture him in videotape so that we can have something to remember. But it turned out that I did 3 Ivory Snow commercials. Those are my first commercials. Of which my mother said, oh, well, okay, we're going to take your time on memorizing the script. Now, I took, for 3 commercials, which is over 200 words, it took me 10 minutes. Oh, I did the commercials, that was it. It took about 3 days, 1 day for each commercial. But then, of course, you know, they want to have the right lighting, they want to have the right position, so it did take about 3 days. And then somebody saw me and said, oh, I love this kid, get him in commercials, just do something. Just get him. So, finally, my mother said, well, he was so good, that we're going to get him someplace. So that's actually how it started.
We have another question.
Okay, excuse me. HL, would you throw it to a spot here? Because we've got to... I'll let you do the break if you...
Okay. We're having a break.
We'll be right back.
I want to introduce you to Diane Bloomgarten, our producer.
You can push the off button and I'll take some back here. I did see it. Yes. Yes. You want
to? I was just wondering, this has to do with any of the young people up there, Arthur or maybe Mason. Do you feel like you've been left out, say, of not Girl Scouts, but Boy Scouts or the regular thing that most of the young people do?
Let's talk to Pam about that for a moment. There what?
Natural. It seems like this has all been planned and I know it's not planned. They're just good.
No, mine.
You should see our show.
Yes.
Pam, I guess they're curious to know how this being on television at such a young age affects your own personal life with girlfriends and friends in the neighborhood and so.
Not much. I never talk about it unless anybody asks me. Because I just, at school, I just want to be normal and I don't want anybody to treat me different. I just act the same as I ever did.
Some people are impressed, though, you know? Some people want to be friends just because you're sort of a celebrity.
No.
You haven't found that to be true.
No.
Have you signed an autograph?
No.
Have no one's asked you?
No.
What?
Have you?
Oh, yeah. I had to sign out pictures.
You did?
So far, I signed out about 5, 6.
Yeah. Now, you're about 3 ahead of me.
Oh, really?
How do you know when someone comes up and, you know, and sort of, hello, Arthur, my friend, and... But is he really like you, or is he just trying to be your friend because you're on television?
Well, half the time, they just want to be my friend because I'm on TV.
Yeah, you can tell.
Yes.
I wonder how you can tell that.
Well, see, I know. I got it up here.
To Arthur, in answering your letters, do you find it very difficult and perhaps maybe hurting someone's feeling, or do you just come out with the answer?
Well, usually. I don't hurt no one's feelings. But some questions are mighty tough.
Have another question.
Oh, you can't reach me. Okay, I got one quick question for Arthur. The name of the school that you go to, and by you going to school, has it affected your school? I mean, by you being on a TV show, has it affected your schooling at all?
Well, my school is OLGH, which is an abbreviation for Our Lady Gate of Heaven. And about, does it affect my schoolwork? No. I can always get my schoolwork when I go back to school.
How much time a week do you spend on the program?
Oh, about 2 or 3 minutes.
But in preparing it, certainly.
How many minutes does it take to prepare it?
Yeah, like, you know, you have to spend, you're there Saturday a long time, huh?
Yeah, till 7:30.
Really? Do you get to choose your material, Jeff?
Well, the Blackhawks tape, Diane set up for me, I have a say in it. I can, if I want to interview somebody, they'll try to set it up for me.
Who would you like?
I don't know.
How about Ali?
Billie Jean King.
You would? You've got so much to choose from here.
I know, but I like them all.
Yeah. H.L., you got
okay,
a question?
Okay, we've got another question.
I'd like to know, where are these children going to be so poised? They're just sitting there like this is no big deal to them at all. Especially Allyson, she's got her little legs crossed.
Okay, well, our producer whips us.
You can ask your question right here. Yes, ma'am.
I would like to direct my question to Allyson. I'm her great-grandmother, and I'd like to know how she feels about, and the rest of them feel about, the older generation.
Well, a lot of, you know, this show is directed basically for kids, but, you know, some adults like it, too, and so, you know, we just, like, for the news stories, a lot of kids wouldn't be interested in it, but some adults would. So we try and make it for all ages.
Thank you.
You must be very proud of Alex.
I am.
Mason, you chatted a moment ago about your, what did you call it, Irish Snow commercial?
Irish Snow.
Yeah.
It's for diapers.
Yeah. It was for what?
Diapers.
You mean for washing the diapers?
No. Irish Snow makes diapers and soap.
I didn't know that.
Well, they used to.
They
used to. Yeah. I don't know if they do now, though.
I would like to share with the viewers a commercial that you made for Irish Snow. I don't even know how old you are here.
I am 4.
You're 4 and a half in this commercial? Ronnie, if you'll roll tape, we'll see. Mason Reese, a long time ago in his career.
Can you remember what it felt like to wear diapers? But we can. When we were in diapers, we couldn't talk and tell you how important softer diapers are. Some of us wore them washed in Ivy Snow. Many of us wore them washed in detergent.
In not a store.
Right. How come every lady doesn't use Ivy Snow?
Sister. One's my oldest brother's 21. My second brother is 20. My sister's 18. My sister is in animal husbandry. My second oldest brother is somewhat. Well, he wants to be in the field of what? I forget. Communications.
Well, he's a travel agent, but he wants to be in the field of communications. And my brother, Lanny, he's a what? What does he do? Yeah, he's in psychology, sociology. And myself, I'm in show business.
We'll be back. Whoever it is that came to see you today?
Well, there's my mother. Mom, would you please stand up for me? And there's my big brother, who I am named after him. Stand up on God. I like calling him that.
And Jeff?
My mom, Elliot.
And your dad.
Hello, my mom's here. And my great grandmother.
So, Dad or Mom, whichever one wants to stand up first. Okay, Mom.
Okay, I've got one person.
I just want to direct this to all the children. I was wondering if your parents treat you any differently because you do this, and do you use it to get things that you want?
No.
No, my mom's here. No. Stand up, Mom.
Yes, excuse me. HL is working so hard with me back here. We didn't end it.
Stand up, Mom.
These parents have done an amazing job of upstaging themselves. They stand up and turn around. We get the back of their head. But that's right. We got you all, I'm sure.
Yeah, my dad's out there. Hi, Dad. Okay. Well, let's see. They don't treat me any differently. I've got two. I've got a brother and a sister. My brother John, 10, and my sister Bumpy. That's her nickname. And boy, they don't treat me differently. Whoa.
How about any of you?
No. Not at all. I don't have any sisters or brothers, but. No, just get to bed.
My brother's still young.
Like always, go to bed at 9 o'clock and wake up at 7.
I'm sorry, Pam.
My brother still yells at me. He doesn't treat me anything.
Oh, he yells at you?
And I yell at him.
Are there any TV programs you're not allowed to watch?
My mom will let me watch anything. She lets me decide. If there's something I don't feel... I don't want to watch. I won't watch it. She'll let me watch.
My mom won't let me watch Bubblegum Digest.
I'm not allowed to watch anything when I'm doing my homework.
How much homework do you do at night?
5, 6, 7 hours.
No, come on. Yeah. About.
We just get homework in every subject, that's all.
You do?
Yeah. That's all.
Yeah. How about you, Mason? Do you enjoy school?
Yeah, I like school.
Really?
Some of my teacher.
Gotcha, David.
No, I like school. My classmates treat me normally. Except for sometimes they want things out of me.
They do?
Yes.
Well, how can you tell?
Well, my friend Chris and Scott come up to me and go, buddy, buddy, when they throw me down on the ground the day before. Then they come up to me the day later and say, buddy, buddy, you know. Obviously, they want something out of me. Yeah. I say, you must want my money.
I wanted to ask you a question, HL.
I know that Bubblegum Digest isn't your first endeavor in entertainment. Was it your idea? I know your parents are actively involved in your career, too. Was it their idea, or was it another person's idea to develop that program?
Well, I have a radio show, and it's on WMAQ at 920, and I have no idea. You'll have to ask Diane how she got my name. Maybe she was listening. I doubt it, though. And she called me up, and I went down there for an interview. And they, Irene and Diane and Audrey, they were all kind of staring at me.
Weren't you nervous?
Was I nervous?
Yeah.
Yes. And I went down there, and then they called me back to tape something. Mm. And this, it was rotten. I thought that was going to be our set, and I said, yeah. You know, it turned out that wasn't our set. We've got a very nice set. Mm. And we taped it, and Diane called me, and she said, you're on. And I went, woo! And she said, is that all your excitement? I said, yes. My parents helped me a lot. My mom helps me clip newspaper stories out of the newspapers, and my whole family helps me, and everybody on the show helps me a lot.
Excuse me just a moment, Rachel.
Are you active in sports at all?
Am I active in sports? Yeah. I play on the Channel 9 softball team. You know, 16-inch, no gloves. I've got the fingers to prove it. I should say sometimes I get to play. It depends, you know.
Good at it?
Am I good at it?
Tell the truth.
I hit 450 last year, which is not, that sounds real good because, but in that league, that's not that good. Most guys hit over 500.
Phil, well, what I want to know, do you take gymnastics, you know? Are you very active?
I do work out sometimes. I'm not as active as I should be. And I... I tell you, for the first time, I noticed that I have a little bit of a tummy. And I really feel kind of bad about that because I want to get rid of it because I want to think I'm young.
Well, now we're getting
even. How old
are
you? We're getting even.
Yes. You keep asking us questions. Now we're going to ask you questions.
I have a problem back here. Problem. Question, actually.
I would like to direct my question to any of the people up front. Do you take any special courses, or did you take any kind of special training before you entered into television or other type of programming, or is this all natural talent?
I've never done anything before this in acting. I've been in school plays, but that's it.
I'm pretty much the same as Pam, except I take piano and ballet.
Yeah, I take piano.
Nothing, you know, in opera.
Well, not the same here. I take piano, and I usually go to acting school. I go to acting school, and then I got sent up here. For about three or four interviews.
We have another question.
And then Diane calls me up, and she says I got the part. I go, oh, God, wow. Out of 140-some kids, you know, I got the part. Oh, wow. Man, I go up my room.
I like to ask Mason, when is he planning to come back to South Carolina to make another commercial?
Well, that I really don't know. Hopefully I will, because I did a very good commercial. Which commercial? Well, I was invited back. Unfortunately, we never had the time. Doing other things, schoolwork and stuff like that. But I do intend to come back.
Mason, would you kindly push a button for me, please? Would you push number 6 on the phone back there, please? Can you find it? Number 6. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're on.
Do you get many fan letters?
Me? Yeah, I when I co-hosted on the Mike Douglas show, I got 500 500 to 600 letters, and I did write back to all of the people, and some of them I sent pictures. So I do get a lot of fan mail for what I do. So,
where do you mostly get them from?
Well, I think the highest rating was in teenagers. I think from 12 to 19, I think was the highest amount of letters I got. But I did get from in the age group of 60 or more, I got about the second highest. So I did get the teenagers was the most mail I got.
You ever have people interview you knowing, well, Mason, how are you? And they treat you like a little boy. And did you ever have someone?
No, everybody's pretty good. They don't ask me mean questions. They don't ask me personal questions. Are you still on the line, aren't you?
Yeah, are you still on the line?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, how nice.
Well, you can chat, but I have to break here right now. You can chat if you'd like. We'll be back in a moment.
Feel at home. I hope you'll ask me back. For me, it's a beginner. I don't like cheats that end, but I'd like to think between us, we both have found a friend.
And we'll say, we've got to go now. Everybody's, our director's waving at me, and I just want to have everybody say goodbye.
Bye.
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 See you.
Bye. Bye.
While in Chicago, many of our guests stay at the Hyatt Regency O'Hare, offering the exciting breakaway weekend 52 weeks a year. Call today or see your travel agent. Some say he has extraordinary powers. Others say he's simply a magician. We'll hear what he has to say about his mystical powers. Israeli psychic Uri Geller on my next show. Join us.